Hello, welcome once again, Beer Goggles Reviews, and I've got a Feakstone Lightfoot. It's not like me eating Lightfoot, I'm a heavy foot, but we've got a Feakstone Lightfoot, which is lovely, refreshing pale beer, it says on there, which I'm looking forward to. Because I've got a first, like a mouth like a camel's arse in a sandstorm, so I'm gagging for it. By the way, the boys down at B14, the best looking bunch of guys looking after the store you've ever, honestly, beautiful, fantastic. One of them standing here with his shorts on, and I'm looking at his legs like, you know, sorry guys, sorry. I've embarrassed them now. But we've got a fantastic beer, hopefully, by Feakstone's brewery, Lightfoot. Now, Paul Feakstone went one way, he'd done the kind of black sheep ales and things like that. We've got the Feakstones, for a little while, went into different ownership, but I believe now they're back in family ownership, so let's see what we've got here. Let's have a sniff, let's have a whiff, have a twirl on the smell, and see what you get. By the way, give your beers a twirl. Little quick hint, if you're down here, if you're at any festival, get yourself a pint glass and fill it up in thirds. Just get thirds all the time. You've got loads of twirling room, loads of room to have a twirl, not spill it all over someone, loads of room to get your face in and have a smell. Slightly kind of like little farty notes in that, but I believe that's off of Burtonisation, to tell the truth. We are talking Burtonisation on that, and it's kind of, as much as it's not always nice, that smell, it's kind of a shape of things to come that you know it's going to be, it's like a good cheese, you know it's going to be punching and bringing those hops up. So let's have a little smell, have a little taste. Cheers everyone, bubbles up. Nice, pleasant, really lovely. You're kind of getting that bitterness, little zest, little kind of lemony flavours in there. You're getting little tangerines there, but you're getting a lot of zest, a lot of bitterness, and in a really nice way. If you're one of these people that's a bit of a lush, that you know, with some of us are, you know, but if you're a little bit of a lush and you kind of don't like, you don't like the bitterness flavours, there's, I would imagine, a little bit of Fuggles in here that's going, it's kind of scratching at your tongue. But if you want to quench your thirst, that will be the one to go for. That will just scrape all that yellow stuff off your tongue. Really lovely. And as I said, I've got a mouth like a camel flip-flop, so let's give this a go. Really lovely. I love those kind of just gentle tangerine background notes. Gentle, lovely malts. That there is a nice beer if you want to go for one that's nice, easy drinking, thirst quenching, and it will follow you home like a naughty dog at the end of the night. That is lovely. Cheers, everyone. Bottoms up. Look at how it shines in the glass. Look, isn't it lovely? Beer's a beautiful thing. It really is. Cheers, everyone. See you down there. See you in the next one, otherwise, don't be late. Cheers.